Hello, my name is Sai, and I'm a senior product manager at AWS Marketplace. In this video, I will be walking you through new features available today for AWS Marketplace sellers, local currency offers and disbursements, and I will show you how you can create private offers in local currencies. Previously, AWS Marketplace sellers could only sell in US dollars. Buyers can choose to pay in invoices in local currencies. However, the invoicing amount from USD to local currencies is only visible to the buyer at the time of invoice receipt. For deals with future invoicing dates and especially multi-year transactions, buyers face the FX variability risk. To address these points of friction, we are rolling out new features that I'll dive into next. Let's go over the scope of what's being launched in the remainder of this year. In 2024, we will be enabling AWS Marketplace sellers to create private offers with contract pricing in four additional currencies and receive disbursements in local bank accounts. More specifically, with this launch, sellers will be able to create private offers using the euros, British pounds, Japanese yen, and the Australian dollars. Sellers will also be able to receive disbursements in that same currency. Next, sellers will also be able to receive disbursements in local bank accounts in eligible jurisdictions like the EU, UK, Australia, or Japan. Finally, buyers will be able to procure software and services from AWS Marketplace without the current foreign exchange variability risk, since they can now be invoiced in the same currency as the seller. Now, first, we need to look at how you can use your local bank accounts to receive disbursements. You can use one bank account to receive disbursements in multiple currencies, or use multiple bank accounts and set up each with a separate currency. If you want to use a bank account located in the UK, you must complete your KYC or Know Your Customer process for AWS EMEA. Please note that the US ACH accounts and Hyper Wallet can only receive disbursements in USD. UK bank accounts can only receive disbursements in EUR and GBP from sales invoiced from AWS EMEA. If you want to learn more on how to add local bank accounts and disbursement methods, please watch our video that guides you through the process of adding bank accounts and associating currencies. Now, a few reminders. Once you have added your local bank accounts and set the disbursement methods, you can now create private offers in contract pricing in non-USD. ISVs need to set the resale authorization in the currency. A channel partner needs to send a CPPO in the same currency. You will also receive disbursements in the same currency as defined in the private offer. Now, I will walk you through a demo of how you can create a private offer in local currency, and I will also show you how you can create a resale authorization for your channel partner to extend a channel partner private offer. Once you log into the AMP portal, you can set your bank accounts and disbursement preferences, including currency association, under the settings tab. This is a prerequisite before you're able to create a private offer in a non-USD currency. To learn more about how you can create the bank accounts and associate currencies, please refer to the video on adding bank accounts and associating currency. Once you have created your bank accounts and associated currency, you can now move to the offers tab and you can click on the create private offers. You can continue to create a private offer by clicking on the create private offer button, and then you can select a product type and the products that you would want to create the private offer in. You can continue creating the private offer the way it is done today. There is absolutely no difference. These private offers can be created using an installment plan, or you can also pay them upfront. For the sake of this example, I'll be using an installment plan. I'm going to use a 2-month installment plan as my duration. this is the new widget that you can see, where you're now able to select the currency in which you want to create a private offer. You have US dollars followed by four other currencies that you have associated in your settings tab. For the sake of this example, I'll be selecting euros. You can select the dimensions. And then you can also enter the quantity of the dimensions. And you can see that the contract total will now be in the non-USD value. So now you can enter the price in non-USD. In this case, it is in euros. And the number of installments. So we are having two installments for this example. We generate an installment plan. You can see all of the values here in euros. You can now add the buyer's AWS account ID to whom you want to extend the offer. You select the contract and you can review and create the offer, private offer that you want to extend to your buyer. The offer currency is clearly listed here in euros. You can see the total euro amount and the payment amount in euros as well. Please ensure that the buyer is able to make a payment in euros, and this is the currency that you and the buyer have negotiated to pay in. With that, you can now create a private offer, and the private offer is now sent to the buyer. Now, I will also show you how you can create a resale authorization for a channel partner. For this, you need to click on the partner tab. Under the partner tab, you click on create reselling authorization. You can give a name to the resale authorization, a description as it exists today. You just select a resale authorization by a seller ID or name. You can then click on the individual pricing or a flexible payment schedule, and you can select the product type. And finally, this is where you will get to see the currencies you can select to create a resale authorization. This should be able to create a resale authorization for your channel partner so that they can extend it to the end buyer. This concludes my demonstration for the resale authorization. Thank you.